It's a festival video, so we're gonna get in the spirit of things. Hello! How are we all doing today? I'm Jake Varley, and welcome to the channel. Brand new thing, I thought I'd try a few things out. Now, this video is all about a festival that was meant to take place this weekend. Right, we are talking about Slam Dunk Festival, which takes place the last bank holiday weekend of May, and it's always absolutely great. But of course, because of the current world we live in at the minute, yeah, I know, COVID-19 has gone and fucked up all our summer plans, including the best things in the world, and that is festivals. Unfortunately, Slam Dunk tried to obviously rearrange for later on in the year, but it's just not worked out, and they're going to move it over to 2021, which we'll look forward to. But today, you know, let's mourn the loss of this fantastic festival, and let's just talk about everything that's good about Slam Dunk Festival. Now, just a disclaimer, all these things, they're my own opinions and from all my experiences. I've been to Slam Dunk Festival for the past 4 years. I've been since like 2016. And so this is just my point of view of everything I've witnessed and experienced at Slam Dunk Festival and also in the north. I've not been to Midlands, RIP. I've not been to the south. So this is just what I've experienced in the north. But it's the same festival, let's be honest with you. The difference isn't going to be much, let's be fair. But all that being said, let's talk about why Slam Dunk Festival is so good. So the first thing that's good about Slam Dunk Festival is the fact that it's the first main festival of the year. I mean, usually it ends with, you know, Leeds and Reading. I know there's a few more festivals like just after that, but the main one, Leeds and Reading, ends with that in August, and that's it. And we're like, well, there's nothing more till next year. Then May comes around, you know, the sun starts to get out. You're like, oh, you can feel it coming. You can feel like you want to be in a field with your mates. And then Slam Dunk's here. Slam Dunk's the first festival of the year, and it's a great way to start the festival season, especially now that they've obviously made it bigger to accommodate for the loss of the Midlands. Because, like, for example, the north, it's moved to Temple Newsom, which obviously where Leeds Fest used to be held, and it just gives it that more of a festival vibe. And it just feels great. So, and I know there's like another festival in Leeds called Live at Leeds, which I think is before that, which kind of is in the slightly similar vein to Slam Dunk of what it used to be, you know, being held in the city centre. But, you know, it's just not on the same level, let's say. And Slam Dunk is amazing, you know, and it makes it even better that it's on a bank holiday, which means that you can start drinking on that Friday, carry on drinking on the Saturday. You know, definitely drink on the Sunday, because the Monday, you know, you don't have work. So it's so good, because it means that you can go all out, and you should, because, you know, there's all the opportunities at Slam Dunk to get absolutely fucked up. The other good thing about Slam Dunk Festival is its location. Now, obviously, there was three locations for Slam Dunk. There was obviously the South, the Midlands, and the North. Now, I know last year they unfortunately got rid of the Midlands and expanded the South and North, which, to be honest with you, when that was first announced, I was a bit skeptical because obviously that meant moving Slam Dunk North to a new location instead of being in the city centre, because I loved it being in the city centre. It was so convenient. It was brilliant. You know, the best thing was when you didn't want to watch a band, you'd go over to a Spoons. And it was brilliant. Better not talk about Spoons at the minute though. But it was great. You could come up on the train and then you were right in the city centre. You were right there, and it was literally just a 2 minute walk, and then you were there at the festival. So that was great. And so obviously when they moved to Temple Newsom, I had to be convinced, that's for sure. But now they've moved it, it gives it that extra level, and it now feels like a proper festival, because you're in a field. Last year we had it all. We started off with great, glorious sunshine, and then by the evening we were piss wet through, completely drenched because it rained. So, you know, it gave it the proper festival vibe. And even though it's not quite in the city centre, you know, it's not hard to get to in the slightest. Slam Dunk have done really well by offering shuttle buses, and that just makes it so easy. So it still means you can go out afterwards. So it's perfect. And Temple Newsom, you know, it's a great place to have it anyway. You know, it held Leeds Fest for many years, so it's a festival vibe. So There's no worrying about that. I don't know much about, obviously, Slam Dunk South. I don't really know how their location is, but from what I'm aware, I think it's pretty similar. So it's just as good. But yeah, it's great. Even though it was slightly better for drinking when it was in the city, it's still just as good to be able to have a full day of drinking because, you know, it's 2020, guys. You know, everywhere should be contactless. No one's carrying cash, especially in this time when, you know, germs can be on cash, right? So nearly all vendors take card, which is brilliant. It's what everyone should do. Obviously, there's some vendors that don't, and that's obviously their decision. But overall, you know, I know all the main bars, they took card and it was perfect. For me, Slam Dunk is all about the day sesh. It's so good. Obviously, it was slightly better when it was in the city. You could pop over to a cheap supplier of alcohol that is has many chains around the country. 20 in Zone 1, you may ask. But having it now at Temple Newsome is just as good because even though you may still be paying premium, you know, festival prices, you know, it's like, you know, £5 a pint, it's contactless. So anywhere that takes contactless in 2020 gets a thumbs up from me because why would you not? It's so easy and more people have it. It's more accessible. So that gets a thumbs up from me for still being able to day sesh all day, which obviously after the festival, you're thinking, well, you know, I've seen you've been day drinking all day. You know, you're probably gonna wanna go back to bed.
Whoa there.
No, you don't, because Slam Dunk has a great addition and that's the Slam Dunk After Party. And the Slam Dunk After Party is great. I've been to most of the ones I've been to, and every time they've been so much fun because it just keeps the day going and it gives you, you know, that extra edge because obviously when you're at a place like Leeds Fest, you've got things like Piccadilly or you've got Silent Disco, so you know the festival vibes keep going. And with it only been a day festival, you're kind of thinking, ooh, well, that's probably it. But no, Slam Dunk hook you up and give you the after party. And it's great. I really recommend going to that if you've not been before because it is good fun. And it just keeps the day going because at the end of the day, if you've not experienced it yourself, you want the day to carry on because it is a fantastic day. Shit. Something I love about Slam Dunk Festival is the bands that they book. Now, I would never say that I'm a big like pop punk fan by any means, but the lineup it always gets bands that I like and it's great. You know, we've got some, you know, bands that I've seen like Panic at the Disco headlining, Enter Shikari headlining, Jimmy World headlining, Bullet for My Valentine, like All Time Low headlining, and obviously 2020 had Don Broco headlining. They get some great headliners, and especially this year, like this year's Slam Dunk lineup was probably the best festival lineup I've seen in a very long time. Probably excluding Reading Leeds 2019, but and honestly, it's they get some great bands, and there's been times when I might only know about three bands that play, but the good thing is I discover so many new bands there because the good thing about Slam Dunk is it's quite close together, it's quite tight. So when you're walking around, you know, maybe looking for some food or wanting to get a drink, you walk past all the other stages and you hear some great bands. I've discovered lots of good bands from going to Slam Dunk Festival. I've discovered Memphis Mayfire, Of Mice and Men, Tonight Alive, New Year's Day, Beartooth, We the Kings. I've discovered loads of different bands and I'm very grateful for that. I always think that for some people that the festival lineup is a make or break deal. You know, some people won't go to festival if they don't know the majority of bands on there. And for me personally, I'm not like that. I think that the whole festival experience itself is enough for me. But I'm very fortunate that Slam Dunk offer me all these new bands, and it's great because I really like them. I think that they get some good bands in and a good mixture. Obviously, around the whole pop punk and metal kind of genre. I've discovered so many new bands and I'm very grateful for it, and especially because of the price that I pay, which is another great factor to Slam Dunk. It's cheap. I think it's about £70 now for the day, which is a fucking bargain, and especially for 2020's lineup. Like, you've got bands like Don Broco, While She Sleeps, who else we got? Billy Talent, The Story So Far, Sum 41. There's so many good bands that you would pay good money to see anyway. And for 70 quid, you would have been stupid not to have bought a ticket. And I really hope that next year, in 2021, it's a very similar lineup, because it's a really good lineup, and if I do say so, I do think it was probably the best lineup of 2020. And like I say, you should get the after party ticket with that. I can't remember if £70 is with or without, but either way, you get that as well, and it's a great deal for a day in bank holiday weekend. You know, there's no better way to spend that money, because you're also spending it on drink as well. And I think the main point of why Slam Dunk is so good is it's just a great day or weekend if you end up going to both. For me, I'm with all my friends, because it's the first festival of the year, so we're going to make sure that we're all together. Bank holiday weekend in May, you kind of, 9 times out of 10, it's good weather. I think it's only rained on me once while at Slam Dunk, and that was last year. Do you know what? I'll take one day's rain over another good fall. I spend the day laughing, because from the off, you know, from driving there in a taxi to the after party, I'm constantly laughing, because I'm with all my mates, I'm surrounded by some good music, and it means I'm in full swing of the festival season, because it's the first one. It's honestly fantastic, and it's a real shame that we're going to miss it this year, but we'll look forward to it next year, because no doubt we're going to come back bigger and better, and hopefully with the same lineup. If you've never been to Slam Dunk Festival before, I highly recommend going, because you won't be disappointed. I've been with one person before, I've been by myself before, and I've been with a group of friends before. I've kind of had a mixture of it all, and every single time it was just as good as the other. It's honestly fantastic, and you won't be disappointed. If you're kind of getting into the whole festival, it's a great festival to start off with, because majority of people are very friendly. It's a festival that you can take the family to. It's a festival that kind of accommodates for everyone. It's very good, and I'm gonna sorely miss it this year, but I can't wait for it next year. So thank you very much. This was why Slam Dunk Festival is so good. I hope you've enjoyed it, guys. This is kind of like my first video like this, so I hope I've done it justice. But you know, give me time. I'll get better. I'll get better at this. Hopefully, I'll probably do some more of these. I'll do some for some more of the festivals I'm going to. Probably download 2000 Trees Leeds Fest for sure, because you know this is stressful times, and you know, missing out on the best thing in the you know, the highlight of my year, you know, festivals is really hard. So I kind of want to take this opportunity for me, but also for you, to kind of reminisce on, you know, all these good times that we have. If you may know, I am also a part of TPD TV, so why don't you go check out one of their Slam Dunk videos and give it a like, to really get a feel for what Slam Dunk Festival is like, and get you excited about it, get you excited about 2021. Don't forget to like and subscribe, make sure you're following all my socials so you can stay up to date with all the content that I produce, and yeah, see you in the next video, guys. Thanks a lot.